right and left kidney along with the ureter and the urinary bladder. This is kidney. It lies in the posterior, on the posterior abdominal wall from T12 to L3, T12 to L3 level. It occupies four quadrant, that is hypochondrium, lumbar, epigastrium and the umbilical as well. Its length is 5 cm, width is 3 cm and thickness is 2 cm. Its anatomical position is, its upper pole is towards medial and backward like this. So the longitudinal axis will run anterolaterally like this. Kidney is not situated like this, there the upper pole should be towards medial side and somewhat backward. Okay, now regarding the lateral axis, it is posterolaterally. The transverse axis runs posterolaterally, they lie in the paravertebral gutter. Okay, now the site determination. The right border, that is the lateral border, is convex, where is the medial border, which is towards the hilum, should be concave. Okay, so this is lateral and this is medial. Now anterior surface should be convex and posterior surface should be flat. So this is anterior and this is posterior. And one thing more, that is this is pelvis. Pelvis, the extension of which is ureter. Pelvis should lie posteriorly in the hilum. So it should go downward untwisted. If I will hold like this, this is going twisted. And if I will hold like this, this will go untwisted. So the ureter is to lie on the posteriormost aspect and go untwisted. So this is of right side and this is of left side. Now kidney is enclosed within the forecovering. From inside out it is true capsule, then perinephric fat, then renal fossa. Renal fossa is again divided into anterior layer of fossa of toll duct and posteriorly fossa of Zucker candle. Both this layer, renal fossa, very important, two lamina, anterior lamina fossa of toll duct and posteriorly fossa of Zucker candle, both unite to form one lamina and continued as conal fossa. Conal fossa, which is attached to the inner surface of the diaphragm, and the reason why it is suspending and even the reason why it moves with the respiration and posture, this conal fossa. Now posteriorly the renal fossa blends with the psoas fossa. Psoas fossa is what? Psoas fossa that lies over the psoas major muscle, and laterally it is continuous with the renal fossa, is continuous with the fossa transversalis, that is fossa over the transversus abdominis muscle, fossa transversalis. And below, the renal fossa is not united, not united, and that's why there is only para renal fat over there. and the reason why the nephroptosis occur in case of starvation, pararenal fat melts down. It is used by the body and the nephroptosis, that is the descent of the kidney, occurs in case of starvation. Okay, one thing more, that the this conal fossa, the superiorly, first it encloses the suprarenal gland. First it encloses, then both lamina separate and enclose again the suprarenal gland, and then become the conal fossa. Okay, and outermost is pararenal fat. So four covering from inside out, it is two capsules, perirenal fat, then renal fossa, and then pararenal fat bodies. Okay, now what is the content of the hilum? From anterior to posterior, it is bhap, that is the renal vein. This is inferior vena cava. This is inferior vena cava, and the right renal vein and the left renal vein. It is worth mentioning here that the left one is larger. This is the reason why the left kidney is suitable for the donation, because left renal vein is longer. Okay, now first comes vein, renal vein, then renal artery. This is renal artery, renal artery, and then renal pelvis. This is ureter, and from here the renal pelvis start up to the lower pole, it is renal pelvis, then it is called ureter. Okay, so this is the position of the structure in the hilum, bhap. From anterior to posterior, it is renal vein, then renal artery, then renal pelvis. Now come to impression. What is the impression over the anterior surface and the posterior surface? First come to right kidney. Here lies the suprarenal gland. Okay, suprarenal gland. Then this is the hepatic impression. Okay, this is duodenal, this is jejunal, this is colonic, this is the model showing the anterior relation of the right kidney. This is kidney, and first this is suprarenal gland. Again the right side suprarenal gland is triangular in shape, whereas in case of left side it is semilunar in shape. So it is suprarenal gland at the top upper pole, and this is hepatic impression of liver. Okay, this is colonic, this is jejunal, this is duodenal impression. So here is the suprarenal, like this suprarenal, then here is the hepatic of liver, this one, then duodenum. So this is duodenal impression, this is jejunal, and this is colonic. Anterior relation of right kidney. Now come to anterior relation of left kidney. Here is, this one is the impression of left suprarenal gland. Okay, left suprarenal gland. This is for spleen. Here is the spleen. This is of pancreas. Here, pancreas. In between the suprarenal and pancreas, this is gastric impression. Gastric impression. Here is the jejunal, and here is the colonic. Okay, this model better explains the anterior relation of the left kidney. This is left kidney. On the top, this is semilunar suprarenal gland. This one, suprarenal gland. This is splenic. What I have said earlier, this is splenic. We also know that at the fundus of the stomach, spleen lies. So, this is splenic and this is gastric. Okay. In the stomach bed, we have learned that there is pancreas. Pancreatic, this is the pancreatic impression. The tail of pancreas is poking into the spleen. So, this is a pancreatic impression. Below the gastric, there is pancreatic impression. Over the superior border of pancreas, splenic artery runs. This red one, splenic artery. So, there is also above the pancreas, this impression of splenic artery. This is tortuous. Okay? And this is jejunal impression and this is colonic. Jejunal and colonic. Right? So, this is about the anterior relation of right and left kidney. Now, come to posterior relation. Posterior relation, in the right side, even in the left side, only few difference are there from medial to lateral. That is, from the hilum towards this lateral border, there is PQT, that is psoas major, quadratus lumborum and transversus abdominis. Three muscles of the posterior abdominal wall, psoas major, quadratus lumborum and transversus abdominis, impression of this. Here is the medial and the lateral arcuate ligament. That margin of the diaphragm, on the medial aspect, this is medial arcuate ligament and here is the lateral arcuate ligament. And also there is ilioinguinal and ilio-hypogastric, then ilioinguinal nerve and vessels passes. Okay? And in the right side, what is the difference in the posterior relation of right and left? That in the right side, only 12th rib impression comes. On the posterior aspect, only 12th rib impression comes, whereas in case of left, 11th as well as 12th rib impression will come, because right one is somewhat at lower position due to the liver. Okay, so this is about the, and also there is subcostal vessels and nerve, medial and lateral arcuate ligament, subcostal vessel and nerve, psoas major, quadratus lumborum, transversus abdominis, iliohypogastric nerve and vessel, ilioinguinal nerve and vessels. 12th rib. Okay, so this is about the kidney, and now this is ureter. Ureter, it starts from the lower pole of the kidney. It has got abdominal part, pelvic part and intramural part. It is 25 centimeter long structure. What other structure which is 25 centimeter long? It is male urethra, also the descending colon, duodenum,
esophagus.
Okay, and least distance of distinct region is also 25 centimeter. So this is ureter, abdominal part. That is up to the pelvic bream. Lower pole of the kidney up to the pelvic bream is the abdominal part. Then before going inside the urinary bladder, it is pelvic part. And while it is traversing through the traversing through the muscles of the urinary bladder is the intramural part. Okay? And one thing more, it is often asked in the viva that what is the site of constriction of ureter? It is 3 in number, that as the at the pelvi-uretric junction. The junction is between the pelvis of the pelvis and the ureter, pelvi-uretric junction. And second one, when it crosses the pelvic dream, there is also relation of common iliac artery and the ovarian artery over the pelvic dream. Very important relation, because it is often during oophorectomy, there is many chances to obstruct the, to ligate the ureter in place of ovarian artery while doing oophorectomy. So it is very important that we should know. And the third one, while it is going inside the, while it is entering inside the urinary bladder, is the third site of constriction. And two more, one in the female and one in the male. In the male, while it is, ureter is crossed by the vas deferens. And in the female, while it is crossed by the uterine artery. Again, very important to know that uterine artery runs above and ureter lies below. That's why mnemonics come, the water under the bridge. Here the bridge is uterine artery and water is the urine running in the ureter. So water under the bridge. And this is the common site of ligation of ureter while doing hysterectomy. And the site is 2.5 centimeter above the ischial spine. That is the site where ureter is crossed by uterine artery. That's all about. Thank you.